Hello everyone, happy Sunday. I did not post Revelation Sunday last Sunday because I had an engagement. I had something that was very important that I had to take care of, and so I thought I would record something today because it's getting late. I've been busy all day, so I thought I would just do an audio instead of skipping the post entirely because I am determined to be obedient to God in this season because it is very important. And whatever season you find yourself in, you have to be obedient to the voice of God. I don't know why this keeps coming to my mind to make sure that I do my best to be diligent, and even if I cannot record a video, I can at least record the audio. And what came to my mind today was the essence of a person, the essence of a person. And so the Holy Spirit gave me this revelation a while back, and it is about aura, A-U-R-A. I hope I'm saying that correctly, but anyway, the aura of a person is the essence of a person. It is the distinctive atmosphere or quality that seems to surround and be generated by a person, a thing or a place. So aura is your character, it's your mood, it's your ambiance, it's your tone, it's your flavor, it's the vibe of a person. So when people say positive vibes or no negative vibes, it's not just about what's in the atmosphere. It's that as a person, we carry a certain essence about ourselves. And so we have to make sure that we pay attention to the aura that we carry about ourselves. Because of a positive aura, some people go for job interviews and they're hired right on the spot before they even get to be interviewed. And because of the same thing, if it is a negative aura, a person can go for job interviews and before they even interview them, they've made up their minds, we're not going to hire that person. And so we have to continue to pray and tell God, God, give me a heavenly aura. Give me an aura that attracts goodness and mercy into my life. An aura that makes helpers of destiny pursue me until they bless me. An aura that makes my life a citadel of your glory. An aura that makes me a repellent to negativity and a magnet to positivity. We have to continue to pray for that. And this, we see the example in the life of Jesus himself, because at the end of the day, this is the standard that we live our lives by, the biblical standard. And we see Jesus, the Bible says, everywhere he went, he was doing good. And the Bible also says in Acts chapter 10, verse 38, it says, our God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. It is the aura of God in you that can make people look at you and favor you, make people look at you and want to help you, and make people look at you and want to bless you. And so today I just want to encourage everyone, encourage you all to let God be the shepherd of your life. Don't leave God out of the equation of your life. Make him your priority. Make him the number one place in your heart, because the Father really longs to fellowship with us. He longs to fellowship with you. And so if you find that your heart has been far from him, make a change today, because you can tell by your aura if you are close to him or if you are not. And even unbelievers can tell when you carry the presence of God, you carry the aura of God, and you carry the essence of God, or you carry the tone of God, the flavor of God, the mood of God, the vibe of God, when you possess the character of God, they can tell, they know the difference. And I know that God is beckoning to us today to come back to Him if we have been far from Him, and that today we can get the true joy back. It is unlike the joy that the world gives. It is flinting. The one that the world gives you is flinting. It is joy, the joy of the Lord, the joy from God, and the love of God is eternal. And so if you are here and you're listening to me and you haven't given your life to Jesus, He knocks at the door of your heart. Why don't you let Him in? Let Him in. His love for you is unmatched. He died for your sake. He rose again that you may live eternally. And so He came so that you will not perish, but that you will have eternal life. And even if you have sinned, the Bible says the Lord is not slack concerning His promise, as some men count slackness. But God is long-suffering towards us. He is not willing that any body should perish, that any of us should perish, but that all should come to repentance. So in order to carry the aura of God today, or if you find that you have been far from God and that the essence of you does not show the character of God, and that you have gone astray, it is time to come back. Give your life to Him today. Guarantee that your past sins will be wiped away by the precious blood of the Lamb of God, given and shed for your redemption. So again, I want to just encourage us today to continue to pray for the aura of God, for the presence of God, to carry the anointing of God. The aura of God tells us apart from people who do not know God. It makes a huge difference. It is a distinctive atmosphere or quality that seems to surround and be generated by a person, a thing, or a place. You are a person. You are a child of God. And if you are today, you must carry the presence of God. You must project the character of God. You must carry the mood of God, the flavor and the vibe of God, not the vibe of the world, not the vibe of what's in vogue now or what people are doing now, but the vibe of God. It sets you apart, and it makes you a person that brings glory to God. So, which is really what this is all about, is bringing glory to the Father. And so I hope that this message blesses you, and I hope that you have a wonderful week. Hopefully I'll be able to post this today to make sure that I meet this deadline that the Holy Spirit keeps poking at me to make sure that I'm obedient. So, all right. God bless you. Have a beautiful week. Goodbye.